her death ruled a homicide 2 years after she disappeared, but tonight it's only stirred up more questions for Katelyn Markham's family. Good evening, I'm Mike Dardis.
And I'm Cherie Palello. How did she die and who killed her? As WLWT News source Jackie Canjado reports tonight, a new chapter in this mystery now begins. Jackie?
Mike and Cherie, it was 2 years ago to the day exactly that Katelyn Markham was last seen alive, and you could say her family is hoping this next chapter will be a shorter one.
Very sad day. Day I've been looking forward to, and a day I've been dreading.
David Markham learned just hours ago his daughter Katelyn's death was ruled a homicide. It's a tough day to be out in public, but he's choosing to share it with the community that's been beside him all along. And together, they're asking for more.
It's been 2 years. You know, everything appeared so normal for her, and just all of a sudden she was gone, and I don't know, we just want answers.
Just days from her 22nd birthday, Katelyn disappeared from her Fairfield home. And in April, her remains were found 25 miles away near a creek in Cedar Grove, Indiana. A missing persons case turned death investigation, now the work of homicide detectives from ISP and Fairfield Police.
They go back into the interviews, they go back into, and once again, I don't know what forensic evidence, if any, that they have. You go towards that, and then you start all over.
Police say it all takes time.
You could never solve a case like this fast enough, and I completely understand that. But in the end, we all want justice for her, and sometimes justice comes slow.
Out here, behind these signs, seconds feel like minutes, days drag into years.
Stop waiting. You know, it's time. So I think somebody knows something, and I'd like for them to step forward.
Katelyn's dad tells us his daughter's remains were released to the family today, and he says that there are plans in the works for a public memorial service so this community that has rallied around him and his family for so long can finally pay their respects. We're live in Fairfield tonight. Jackie Canjado, WLWT News 5.